frog things. Hey. Heard about the slicer. Brave of you to fight a beast like that. Foolish too, you know. You got guts, but you won't last long. Hey, I almost had it. It would have been fine even if the salt hadn't shown up. I know! Have you added this game to your wish list yet? Cause you should. It is a very you game. There's something going on with my avatar. Sure. Hey, getting settled in yet? I'm working on it. I still need to finish decorating and stuff. Ah, decorating is a job that's never done. Sure, you can be satisfied with how your place looks for a little bit. But the satisfaction never lasts. So true. You'll find new things to throw on the shelves, or you'll have new ideas, or you'll get bored. It never ends. You make it sound like a curse or something. Oh, sorry, do I? I don't mean to. Personally, I think it's lovely that you can redecorate your home at any time. People are constantly changing, and their homes are a reflection of that. It's not wrong, people are constantly changing. You don't want to talk to me.
Hello.
Hey, has training started yet? Training's later in the day.
Oh.
Oh! Do you know where Aldo Pufo is? You wanted me to go talk to him this morning.
Boss.
I don't know. Probably at his house or something. Thanks! Huh. Hey, before you go.
Huh?
You might be on Bufo's good side, but I'm the guild leader here. Bufo can train you all he wants. It's my choice whether or not you're part of the defense guild. You may have survived that fight, but I still had to bail you out. So don't get your hopes up. I guess we'll just have to see, then. Good luck proving me wrong. Well, I will prove you wrong. So, Chameleon, how has your day been? I have had a day, and I am just glad I am able to stare at frog things, because, let me tell you. The way this morning was going, I wasn't sure I would feel well enough to stream tonight. And her final words before her passing were, "The final dawn approaches. The coldest winds shall grace the land. The schnicked." The schnicked? Yes. Bufa, is there something you are not telling me? was just a story invented during the war to scare you. I knew the frog who dreamt the story up. Have I not told you this already? The war was ages ago. Do you not find it strange that such a young frog know this old tale? I can't argue with that, but it's just a myth. Someone must have brought the story back. I hope, for both our land's sake, that you are right. Goodbye, Elder Boofle. Excuse me, priest.
Dial.
Hello.
Dial.
Oh, good morning, Chorus. What's the schnicked eavesdropping, eh? No, I was just... It's all right, Chorus. I am just teasing. Yeah, I hear ya. I mean, I actually, like, enjoy my job, but with fibromyalgia, everything is tiring, so... Yeah. But we're not here to think about sad things, we're here to think about frog things! Are you staying cool, Chameleon, and hydrated? Because it's hot. Damn hot! Fool, I tell you, it's hot! Man, I need to watch that movie again. The Schnicked is just an old ghost story we made up in the war to scare the enemies. It's hardly anything to be concerned about. Although, I am curious as to why the story has returned. I will have to ask the other elders if they have heard similar stories.
Anna.
Aside from that, Chorus, I am glad you stopped by.
Mia.
How come?
Mio.
I wanted to ask what you think of Borrelia so far. I know it has only been one day, but first impressions are very important. Oh, it's fine. Do you mean that? I have seen how the guild members treat you. No, I do mean it. Good, because it's hot. Did I mention it's hot? The other warriors... It's just... It's nice. Borrelia is a really sweet village, and I am really happy to be here.
Oh.
I guess I'm disappointed. All the stuff Basalt said. I moved here to get away from that sort of thing. Feels easier being here, though. It feels like, back home, everyone has a picture of me in their heads. But it isn't who I am. Here, nobody has expectations of me. I don't have to feel that pressure here.
Oh.
So I am happy to be here.
Enough.
I think I understand. I am sure that together we can get the other warriors to be more considerate. Oh, there was one more thing I wanted to talk to you about. One more thing! I hope this does not come off as rude, but I'd recommend taking your blade to Rimmel. He's the blacksmith in Borrelia.
Mio.
Trust me when I say that he is the finest blacksmith you will ever meet. He will be able to determine if your blade is up to Defense Guild standards. That might not be a bad idea. One more thing! Oh, I bet you that show has not held up great. But it could have. It could have. I felt like Gummy Bear Adventures held up pretty good. Gargoyles held up really good. Thank you for talking with me. If there is more you wish to discuss, I am always here. But if I'm not around, you could always talk to Raina. Her house is the closest one to the path away from Borrelia. Here, I will put a pin on your map so that you do not forget. Thanks. I'll see you around.
Hi.
Hiya.
Who was that frog who was just here? Ah, that was Elder Brevi. He is the Elder of Pema, a little village in the Drylands. fought a lot during the war. But the two of us came to an understanding one day after we ended up in a life or death situation together. Where would I find Rimble? His shop is near the eastern edge of Borrelia. You likely passed by it when you first got here. Yeah, I was just wondering about it this morning. Cool, thanks.
Mia.
Can you tell me more about the Schnitt? Ah, fan of myths, are we? During the war against the Drylands, a Salian soldier had an idea of how to get the edge over the rain frogs. He told us about a nightmare he had the night before and how it had inspired him. The plan was to convince the enemy we had a secret weapon. A terrible, towering beast known as the Schnitt. He claimed it was capable of incredible destruction, and we would unleash it if we had to. Said that the mythical Sunblade was the only thing that could kill the Schnicked. Of course, we claimed to also have the Sunblade, so that we would be the only ones capable of stopping it. Oh, I know about the Sunblade. The old stories say that Honora created it. Apparently, she blessed it so that it would be able to kill any monster. I didn't pay much attention to the old stories when I lived in Tensfall, but I did like the ones with the weird monsters. I did not care so much for the stories of monsters when I was younger. They never seemed to have a moral. Sometimes a story can just be about a goddess fighting a giant crab, and that's okay. That's beautiful. I agree with you. Sometimes a story can just be about a giant goddess fighting a giant crab. That's totally valid. You're right. Interesting thing about Borrelia's history. A few years ago, there was a ghost sighting.
Whoa.
Really? What happened?
Neil?
Someone saw a light floating above the sea.
Ooh.
And then? No, that's it. They just saw a light and told everyone it was a ghost. Oh, that's kind of disappointing. I was hoping it would be like a sailor that had died under mysterious circumstances 100 years ago or something. Not much really happens here other than all the defense guild stuff. But I kind of like that. It's relaxing. Not to mention, it makes my job easier. Do you play music? Huh? Oh, the piano. Yes! I'm not very good at it, but I don't know. That's what's nice about it.
What?
What do you mean? It's one of the only things I do other than the elder training. I do it just for me. There's an entire village counting on me. I don't need to care about being good at it. I can just play piano. That does sound nice.
Mia.
I don't think I really have anything like that. I guess I doodle sometimes. But I don't want to be an artist or anything. That's exactly what I mean.
Mia.
It's good to just do things without worrying about trying to be the best. Steel waiting for me at the forge in the Copper City, and I need someone to pick it up.
Oh.
The Copper City? Everyone's so pretentious there. Hey, it's not that bad. I was born and raised there. Oh, sorry. If you were raised somewhere like the Copper City, why would you move somewhere like Borrelia? too pretentious there. Look, if you can pick up that steel for me, it would help a lot. Why can't you get it? I'll just be honest. I don't really like walking. That's it? If you get it for me, I'll touch up your blade for a discount. Could you do it for free? What? What kind of deal is that? I mean, you're making me walk to Copper City just because you don't feel like doing it yourself. There's probably monsters on the way to there. On the way there, too? I doubt it's the safest trip. I feel like touching up my blade for free is a pretty good trade for that. And what if I refuse? Then you better get walking. You've got an attitude, kid. I like you already. Meet me in my shop and I'll take a look at what you're working with. I mean, I'm not wrong though. Alright, let's take a look at that blade. My soul, is this salamander steel? That's not something you see every day. I kind of went all out when I got it commissioned. I guess I was hoping if I got the best blade I could, it would make up for my skills. Listen, pal, you can give the worst painter in the world an amazing brush, and their work will still be a load of mud. Likewise, the world's best painter can make something gorgeous using a single blade of grass. So believe me when I say, it's not the blade that makes the warrior. But I'll be the first to admit that salamander steel is pretty impressive. The material of this blade is high quality, but it's lacking craftsmanship. Here, let me sharpen it up a bit. Give me just one moment. Here you are. I've sharpened it a tad for you. I'll be able to sharpen it a bit further, but given how difficult salamander steel is to work with, I'd need payment for my efforts. After that, if you want further improvements, I'll need an ingot of salamander steel. We can talk again after you're back with my order. To get to the Copper City, just follow the northern path away from the village. Take a left at the fork in the path there. And hey, while you're there, if you end up eating at Grubby's, tell the big guy I said hi. City, here we come. Still on the lookout for some worms, though. Still don't know how to kill those things. Thank you. what it's made out of? Some sort of soft, flexible metal? Reminds me a bit of a tree branch, or maybe a staff? Wait, do you think this thing is a magic staff? I don't think magic is real. Okay, but if it was, this would definitely be a magic staff, right? Yeah, sure, Espo, it would be a magic staff. I guess so? Whatever it's made of doesn't really look natural. Exactly. Magic materials. Just between you and me, my guess is that this magic staff is extremely powerful. With this and my shield, I'm gonna be unstoppable. For those of you who are wondering, you actually can turn on an invincibility. I have turned on auto heal, and there is an invincibility mode. If you just wanted to play FrogSong for the story, you can totally do that. As you can see, I am not super great at beating up enemies, but I am going to try to do it with the auto heal and not the invincibility mode. For at least for now. But I think it's really neat that they included those options for people. Like, you can make it as hard or as easy as you want to. Hey, I finally got behind that thing and did the thing. Insect gate does not. I don't know that this is working very well. There are insects on either side of the gate. Wow. Copper City is a long way away. Definitely the free blade thing. If you didn't have a thing, you can also rest. Look at how adorable it is. Hello! Hello there. What do you think of the sculpture I'm working on? It looks neat. What exactly is it? Not sure. I just like making these sort of shapes. I use clay from the road of this pool, then I let it dry out in the sun. It's really fun. That sounds fun. I'm gonna get back to working on this one. The loops aren't quite right yet. Okay. super sure what these anti-insect gates are for again. If there's insects on both sides, I feel like they're not working. Oh! Secret door! Secret door, secret door, secret door, secret door. Thank you. dig sometime later. I'm headed towards Cobber City with my frog and my beetle buddy. Says that Mecha's eyes sparkled a brilliant blue color. Such a beautiful blue that Anura colored the seas after them. I'm pretty sure Meku dies horribly at the end of that story. Oh, what are the creeps doing? Time is coming to an end, size or not. Huh. What's going to happen to Borrelia? Wretched brat, you really think your village is important? My plans are far bigger than you realize. Borrelia is puny and weak. It means nothing to me. I have my sights set on something far larger. You're lucky as I'm in a good mood as I just finished discussing arrangements for the Copper City to join my empire.
Oh.
What? So I'll let you live for now. Run back to your little village and continue your holy studies while you can. I'm not a scholar. I'm in the Defense Guild. Cute. Run along now, little boya. Go back and whine to your pitiful village. Whatever you're up to, it isn't going to work. Who goes there? My name is Chorus. I'm just messing with you. It's my first day as a guard. I've always wanted to say that. Halt! Who goes there? Stop right there! Classic guard stuff. Well, good luck with the job! Thanks! I'm suddenly even tinier than normal. Fare to travel is 5 pennies. Care to travel? No. Stay safe out there. Did you know the Copper City wasn't always the bright, clean city everyone knows it as? Not a lot of people know this, but it used to be quite the hot spot for smugglers and pirates. I was born in the wrong generation. Hello. I'm here to pick up an order. Boom. That's right. Here. Thank you. Be careful out there. Strange whispers going around. Ever since that bullfrog empire guy showed up. Talking about some sort of monster.
What?
The Schnicked? Yeah, I think that was the name. Well, thank you again for the steal. Tell Rimble I hope he's doing alright. Everybody's talking about some sort of monster. I'm not buying it though. Some 50-foot monster that's gonna come stomp through and kill everyone? I mean, yeah, there's monsters everywhere, but nothing can be that big. Hello there. Would you like to play that old cup game? Well, I'm sure you know the rules. I swap the cups around, you follow the cups with the beads in it. If I pick the cups with the beads in it, you win. I can pay $5 for each chance to win 10. Or play a harder game. 10 for 1. 30. I'll play one game. Alright, you're paying attention? Watch closely. And there you go! You're a winner! Okay, I did it! I'm not gonna play again. Attracted, but kind of just barely. Well, you didn't hear what the Emperor said as he came through? He said the Copper City is going to get attacked by a horrible towering beast. What did he call it again? A Schnicked? Oh my. I've never heard of a Schnicked before. Is it dangerous? The Emperor said it's very dangerous. Don't worry, though. He also said he could protect us. Oh, if that's the case, then it'll all turn out okay, alright. I've heard Tor has quite the army. Going around the outskirts, checking all the things out. Pewter the Wretched, Third Elder. What? I'm going to assume that's Numi. Know me, just on a different account. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's right, you're out playing Magic tonight. Well, look at this adorable frog, Nomi. Look at this adorable frog. Super fucking cute. And I have a beetle bunny. Embo the Swift, second elder. Malda the Brave, first elder. Mossel the Wise, fourth elder. Frosel the Giving, fifth elder. Drop the Generous, sixth elder. Okay. Hello. I like your hat. It's really pretty. It seems I am a bit stuck. Stuck? What do you mean? The moment I move, I just know this flower will take flight in the wind. So I am stuck here. Oh. The cost of being cute. Oh, do you want a piece of cheesecake? I have an extra piece that I'm not going to eat. Really? Sure. Here you go. Thanks! Tell me about it. The cost of being cute is high sometimes. Oh, you make knit plushies! Oh my gosh! You made plushies and they're so cute, I want them. Can I buy them? Hello, would you be interested in purchasing a cute cuddly plushie? When is the answer ever? No! All handcrafted and locally made by me! These plushies would be a lovely way to decorate your home. The first plushie I have for sale is a cute little Poglet plushie. Sell it to you for 20. Are you interested in buying it? Abso-fucking-lutely. Thank you. You got the Podlet plush. You can collect special items to decorate your home. You'll also unlock new items at the end of each chapter, so make sure to check your chests at home. Hello. The second plushie I have for sale is a cuddly Skitterbug plush. It's bigger, so it costs a bit more. I can sell it to you for 30. Raise your prices. Are you interested in buying it? Abso-fucking-lutely. Thank you. You got the Skitterbug plush. Hello, the last plushie I have for sale is a big Blugger plush. This one's pretty big, so unfortunately it won't be so cheap. I can sell it to you for 50. Raise your prices. Yes, I am interested in buying it. I want it all. I am going to tweet to them that they need to have him raise his prices. Thank you for supporting local business. Goodness, do you think that mobster's real? I don't know, but rather safe than sorry, right? Guess so. I don't much like that Lord Lithos, though. Good, you shouldn't. He's creepy. We don't like Lord Lithos. We do not stand Lord Lithos in this household. Hi! Are you from the Copper City? I'm just passing through. Me too! Have you had any food here yet? I've heard the honeydew is delicious. There's so many kinds of snacks in Salia, it's so exciting. I'm traveling around trying all sorts of food. One day, I hope to try every single snack in the world. That's a lot of food. Good luck! Hello. What are you up to? Oh, hello! I'm reviewing the plans for a new art gallery. That's going to take a while to build, but I think it'll look very nice once it's done. This is my first big project with the construction team. I'm so excited. They let little tree frogs into the construction team? Of course. Sure, we can't hit a hammer as hard or carry as much stone, but we can do things big toads can't. I wish the Defense Guild would realize that. Welcome to Grubbies. What can I get for you? What's up? Ha! Still getting other studio's chores for him, is he? He always was one of my favorite customers. When you get back, tell him to get his butt down here. Tell him I miss him. Actually, wait. Don't tell him I said that. Maybe don't say it's specifically me who misses him or anything. Maybe forget I said anything. Ooh, somebody has a crush on Brimble. Me? I'm the grubby this place is named. I was never really sure what I wanted to be when I grew up, but one day I realized I just really like food. Who doesn't? I wasn't half bad at cooking either. Figured I'd try opening up my own little eatery, give it a year or so and see how I feel. And the rest is history. I grew up in this city, moved away for a bit, but I kind of missed the place. Eventually, I came back and opened my little restaurant. It is so cute. I cannot describe the level of cute in this game. Your frog is non-binary. And there's already been a gay frog couple. They gave me pie. And I'm pretty sure he has a big crush on Rimmel. The Copper City is certainly not the worst place to live. I mean, sure, most of the people living here wouldn't know a good meal if it grew limbs and lunged at them, but there's a good few customers who stop by. At least I'm making enough to keep this place running. As he passed through here, something's gonna come around cutting people.
Huh?
What? Yeah, he said something about a monster and something along the lines of the snip is coming. Not very good grammar, if you ask me. It's still scary, though. I don't know about you, but I'd rather not get snipped. I think he said the snicked.
Oh.
Hey, you're a tiny little frog. Do you want to make a big splash? I've got just the thing for you.
Whoa.
See an ugly crumbling wall?
Boom!
Bang! Surrounded by monsters?
Boom!
Bang! I love his little boom. Just want to see a really cool explosion? Ready, ready?
Bombo!
Oh, so cute. Bombs! Yes! Do be safe with them, though. You could really hurt yourself if you use them wrong. You can buy 6 bombs for 20 or 12 bombs for 35. Good. I needed some bombs for blowing up walls. In honor of Maldar the Brave, founder of our prosperous city, may your legacy live for ages to come. Hello! Do you have a moment to talk about our holy songstress, Sazandora? I'm a tree frog. I lived in Entowol my whole life. I know all about Sazandora. Of course, I'm sure. Have a moment to talk about her anyways? Yes. Oh, really? I've never gotten this far before. I don't have anything prepared. Come back tomorrow?
Yeah.
Ouch. Well, at least I got the prompt to go away.
Oh.
Okay, I've got all the bombs now. Yep, you know. Hey, I gotta blow up some walls, man. What's the best way to blow up a wall you know of? Bombs. Welcome, little tree frog, to the shop of Aphidius. If you're looking for the finest honeydew in all of Salia, you've come to the right place. Whether you want spiced, sweet, or bitter, I only sell the best. A bottle of Aphidius honeydew will leave you refreshed beyond belief. A bottle of honeydew will heal you fully, and then some. If you'd like a bottle, it will cost you 85. Purchase a bottle of honeydew? Sure. Why not? I'll just buy everything. I have no idea how much it's gonna take to upgrade my blade, but I'm buying everything anyways. Why not? I can always just go out and farm some more. Good afternoon, ma'am. Or sir? Or, neither. I'm not a girl or a boy. Oh, that's cool. I didn't know you could do that. But what's the not girl or boy version of ma'am and sir? That is the question. I don't know, actually. That's okay. I'll make one up. Have a good rest of your day, Smurm. Maybe keep workshopping it. There's a book on the shelf titled Musings on the Podlet. Reezy? Yes. I am supposed to be writing my next great story, but nothing is coming to mind. If I cannot write the final story for my book, I will not be able to publish it and make a living. I sit here in the shade as the hot summer sun filters down, trying to dredge words from the depth of my mind. A podlet climbs upon the moss in front of me. Finding its way through life with its tiny feelers, the podlet moves with gentle purpose. The podlet cares not about money or work. The most pressing matter in its life is finding a good meal. Don't we all wish that was the most pressing matter in our life? A good meal is not hard to come by if you are a podlet. A simple mushroom or dead leaf will suffice. The podlet's life is simple. Perhaps one day I will be able to live more like the untroubled podlet. There's a book on the shelf titled Culture and Practices of the Ancient Civilization of Salia. Read it? Yes. Centuries ago, life in Salia was very different. Many believe that the ancient civilization disappeared one day, but the truth is likely much more mundane. It likely evolved into our modern civilization with their culture and practices disappearing over time. It is currently unknown what caused such a drastic shift in culture. In this book, we will be focusing on three major customs of the ancient Salians: water worship, death rituals, and dream reading. Keep reading? Yes. Water worship. Ancient Salians believe water to be the source of all life, and in a way it is. They saw water as holy, sentient force, and would build shrines to collect rainwater. It is believed the purpose of these shrines was to give water a dignified place to rest before it returned to the clouds. Keep reading? Yes. Death rituals. The ancient Salians were very connected to written nature. Their culture had a strong focus on our life cycle, growing from simple tadpoles in the water to full frogs. Their rituals surrounding the dead are surprisingly similar to modern death rituals. The body of the recently deceased would be adorned in heavy jewelry, chains, and gifts. After saying a prayer to the water, the body would be placed into a river or pond and gently sink to the bottom. The philosophy behind this ritual was quite simple. We are born in the water, so we must return to the water. This is an incredibly similar ritual to what is done today, though in modern times the deceased is often placed inside of a stone jar, as per Inaran tradition. Yes. Dream reading. Dream reading was an ancient practice in which frogs would rest in specialized temples. These temples were built in locations they believed contained faint interstices between our world and a spirit world. They believed sleeping in those locations would allow them to see into the spirit world through their dreams. Upon waking, they would try to recount their dreams, hoping to pull a lesson or a prediction out of them. Often, frogs would only dream read during times of personal struggle. There's a story on this shelf titled The Twisted Queen. Read it? Yes. Long ago in the land of Carton, there was a kingdom simply known as the Twisted Kingdom. The Twisted Kingdom existed underneath the ground, behind an ancient mountainous redwood tree. Spacious stone tunnels with perfectly paved roads wound deep into the earth. Whispers claimed some of these tunnels reached the bottom of the world. None of these tunnels reached the surface. Roots of the great tree marbled the walls of the kingdom. The Twisted Kingdom had a beautiful city center with a gorgeous series of pools. Towering pillars of stone touched the ceiling of the spacious chamber. There were dozens of shops, thousands of homes, and a barracks for any guards that would protect the kingdom. This kingdom was ruled by a toad simply known as the Twisted Queen. She was a beautiful toad, strong, stout, and well-fed. Her power was unquestionable, as was her claim to the Twisted Kingdom. The Twisted Queen loved her kingdom. She was truly the only one fit to rule. Some days, she would stroll the extensive streets. While strolling, she would sing to herself. All are happy, those who live here, all are happy in my land. someday she would browse the shops. While browsing, she would sing to herself. Those who left us long forgotten, those who left us lost in sand. Some days she would visit a few homes. While visiting, she would sing to herself. Down the tunnels, hear the murmurs, down the tunnels, do not hop. Some days she would soak in the pools. While soaking, she would sing to herself. In the morning, follow the light, in the morning, to the drop. One evening, the Twisted Queen was wandering through the northmost neighborhood of the kingdom. She passed by a stone home built into the wall of the tunnel. The Twisted Queen approached the home and peered into the window. There was no one sitting on the chairs. There was no one at the stove cooking dinner. There was no one sleeping in the bed. After a minute or two, the Twisted Queen kept walking. As she walked, the Twisted Queen heard a voice echoing down the tunnel. She froze. The Twisted Queen spoke a few words aloud to confirm to herself that it was not her that she heard speaking. She quickly began to walk back to the city center. She was scared. She was not used to hearing a voice other than her own. After all, no one but her lived in the Twisted Kingdom. The queen turned a corner and realized she did not recognize this tunnel. This tunnel sloped downwards. She heard the voice behind her once again and decided to continue. As she traveled deeper into the earth, she began to laugh at herself. How silly for her to imagine she heard a voice. It simply could not be real. After all, no one but her lived in the Twisted Kingdom. She walked for what felt like hours. Eventually, she came to a stop. In the middle of the road ahead of her was a steep drop-off. The Twisted Queen peered over the edge into the pit before her. There were voices coming from the bottom. Suddenly, the Twisted Queen heard rapid footsteps behind her from the tunnel. With a powerful leap, the Twisted Queen jumped to the other side of the pit. The footsteps were getting closer. She continued down the tunnel, running faster than she could ever remember running. The tunnel traveled deeper and deeper into the earth. The queen kept running. The footsteps were getting closer, and she could hear the voice again, this time much louder. The Twisted Queen reached the end of the tunnel and ran out into an open chamber. She looked around. She knew this place. It was the city center of her beautiful kingdom. She looked back at the tunnel she had run from, only to see the road to her castle. The footsteps were gone. The voice was gone. The Twisted Kingdom was quiet once again, and it was perfect. Isn't my darling Cobalt just so beautiful? She wasn't cheap either. I got her imported from some faraway island. Her shell is naturally shiny already, but I make sure to polish her shell every day to give it that gorgeous glimmer. She is quite pretty. But Hank is pretty cool too. I think it's time to take my load back to Copper City.
Thank you.
girl! I know this is what you've been waiting for. You've been desperately waiting for it. Ooh, it's a puzzle. Let's see if I can do it without reading the hint sign. Almost bow for the king. Ah, so I have to get them all down. I'm gonna guess. Adjacent to it on a grid. Need more info. No. Okay, so. I hate these kind of puzzles, just saying. Least favorite. And one more hint. Default positions. Oh! Huh! Well, guess what? Well, let's reset to default. I didn't actually read what that said. Thank you. really hate this kind of puzzle. I am not good at it. Oh boy. Okay. Top row left, top row right, bottom middle, bottom right. Top left, top right, bottom middle, bottom right. Top left. I'm really good at word puzzles and logic puzzles, but spatial stuff like that, for some reason, my brain is like, I don't understand. And I gave it a few goes, so I don't feel, like, bad about that. There's one other place that I know that I need to use a bomb. Still haven't seen any sign of worms. Just a giant frog I know is looking for worms. Also have figured out there's definitely like time passage stuff in this game, because several people have asked me to come back like later.
Mm-hmm.
Buddy is frog proof. Or bomb proof. Bomb proof. That's what I mean. Grab lily stone. Yeah. Frogs in chat! Give me frogs. Hey, you got the steel? Awesome! The person working at the forge wanted me to tell you that she hopes you're doing good. Aw, Kilna. She's always such a softie. Thanks for getting this for me. Let me know what you'd like when you'd like for me to touch up your blade again. I will! There's something I need to talk to Elder Bufo about first, though. Actually, I've got an update on the snicked situation. I went to the Copper City and people were talking about it. Lithos was there too. Someone said that everyone started talking about the snicked after he showed up. Do you think that's the disaster he was talking about yesterday? Oh, for home's sake. I really should have known that it was Lord Lithos. First the attempted Slizer attack and now the snicked. He must be trying to cause panic. The exact same reason we invented the story during the war, to threaten the enemy with a made-up beast that only we could stop. The Tall Empire seems to be a bigger threat than they first appeared. Come and see me tomorrow morning, Kos. I will come up with a plan tonight on how we can stop the rumor from spreading. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow. Let me go up and get my blade. Damn it. I did. I talked to him. Okay. Achoo! I think it wants me to go to sleep. Not before decorating my house, though. I got a flower as well as my plants. This is great. Little squeaky noises. Chapter 3, Back Home. It's raining! My blade yet. Hey, welcome back. Looking to upgrade your blade again? I can sharpen it some more for 100 coin. Yes. There we go. Your blade has been upgraded. Extra sharp achievement unlocked. I'll be able to improve it further if you can get your hands on some salamander steel. Talk to him. I wanted to tell him Rimball or Grubby has a crush on him. Is everybody inside because it's raining? My friend was telling me earlier. Some sort of giant monster was supposed to be coming. Something about the story doesn't add up to me, though. What do you think? It's fake. I don't really think it's real. I don't know. Either way, the story's a little bit unsettling. Lovely weather, isn't it? The sea rain is always so refreshing. I thought frogs would like rain, but then I didn't see anybody outside, so I was like, maybe they're hiding. Gonna go check in on Raina for the day? Oh! Raina's gone! Turns out when you inhale dust and dander and dog hair for a living, it gives you the sniffles. I set my plushies up in my home. I got plushies in my home. here. Maybe he's outside? Oh, good morning, Curse. Good morning, Elder Buffalo. Such wonderful weather we're having. I was just taking in the air for a moment. Sometimes it's important to simply exist. That structure in the distance. What do you suppose it is?
Maya.
I'm not sure. I guess I never thought about it.
Meal.
Appears to be massive. Perhaps it was built by the ones who walked before us. I wonder what secrets it holds.
Oh no.
Ah! I was hoping that would happen. There must be a storm on its way. Every time it storms, lightning strikes that large tower. I've always wondered why a structure would be built to be struck by lightning. Anyways, how are you doing this morning? I'm alright. You said you had a plan for the Lizzo situation? Yes. If people learn of the schnick through Lizzo's rumors, they will undoubtedly panic. But if someone were to warn them before Lizzo arrives, they might know better. I've already sent warriors to Redwood and Clear Bay to warn their elders. Assault is ready to head out as well, but she is standing by until I get your answer. Answer? Well, you see, I believe the elders would be more receptive to someone they already know. If you spoke to your old elder, it's more likely that he would believe you. You want me to go back to Tensfall? I know you had a hard time there. If you're not comfortable going, Basalt will. You can head to Mossfen instead. No. I'll do it.
Mia.
Despite everything, I'll still do what I can to protect Tensfall.
Mia.
If you're sure, then Basalt will go to Mossfen. You will head to Tensfall. I'm sure you know the way. Just explain the situation to Elder Akris. Hopefully we can end this invasion before it truly begins. Some of them collect water, some of them do not. Hmm. did I just pick up? Mysteriously fizzy sip. This vivid teal liquid sparkles with strange stinging bubbles. It has a slightly sweet, sickly sweet flavor similar to tropical fruit. Sparkly jelly juice! Yes, it is! Hello! Have you come to enjoy adorable frogs with me? When the button doesn't work. Well, that's fine. You can enjoy adorable frogs while you're working. Lurking. Okay. That was a little weird glitch, but it's all solved now. Alexa, turn on desk light. Absolutely killed them with kindness with a customer this morning. And so I literally put on my phone. Kill them with kindness. Kill them with kindness. And it was great. But that was in the back where the customer couldn't hear me. But yeah, this customer was being really rude, insisting that we lose his information every time he comes. And he used to go to the Hancock Center one. They always lost his information. They never had it saved. Well, guess what? When you look up Hancock Center, there is one thing that is there, and one thing that is not. The one thing that is not is there is not a PetSmart, but there definitely is a Petco. I did not tell him that. I was not brave enough. And down, left, and right. I've been coming here for years, blah, 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 blah. And we used to have Petco right across, like, from us at my old store. So we would literally call the Petco up after the customer left and be like, hey, can you look this up and see it? And they'd do the same. Can you look this up and see if these guys have an account with you? And, no, definitely always had an account at the other store. Years though. Okay. What? figured that one out all by myself. They claim that it's the same store. They always claim it's the same store they've always been going to. And inevitably, it's totally not. And it... you can't convince them otherwise. We'll even say, are you sure that wasn't a Petco most of the time? And they'll just be like, I think I'd know the difference. I've been coming to this store for like, with my dog for like 7 years. Mm-hmm. Sure you have. Okay then. Anyways, this guy was like, me just not even being fazed by his luster and blah blah blah, and like being like, okay, well, here's how we can solve this situation, let's get this done, and just being like, oh well, I'm so sorry about that, but let me figure this out for you. And he just like, his tone went down, like literally everybody was like, oh my god, the immediate tone guys, the frog that finds all the stupid human things has found a worm on the string. Guys, we thought it couldn't get better. We thought this game, every time you think this game can't get better, it's just like, oh really? Let's throw you a curveball.
Hiya.
Hey, Espo. Oh, hey. I'm gonna be completely honest with you. I have no clue what this is. I mean, it looks like it's supposed to be some sort of creature.
Huh.
It's furry, and it's got fake eyes. I have no clue what's up with the string.
Huh.
Wait, the string might be the key to it all. What do you mean? It's bait.
What?
It's not bait. Aren't there stories that say this forest used to be filled with magic monsters? Maybe some of them are still around. Looking at this bait, whatever it is, it's gotta be real weird and real creepy. With this bait, I'm gonna catch it. Espo, please don't. Please don't. You're not ready to fight anything like that. So there is a AD model that does worm on a string. There are also many. A friend created a giant worm on the string plushie with a inner pocket, and that you can loop around. And now, like, that's what my friend Mutt is just now like making a bunch of them because everybody wants one. Huh? Hello? I am a bee from beyond. I can't see you on the tree there. No, you can't eat my words. Forces of power and malice have begun to emerge. Huh? I implore you, child of the woods, stay vigilant, lest you encounter danger far stronger than yourself. And remember to stay hydrated. Gonna take that as a hydrate. Water. Are you just out here messing with people who walk by? No. Leave now. do a double hydrate then. I mean, I already treated it like a hydrate and hydrated, so I'm now doubly hydrated. Well, that was a new one. Should have made somebody clip that. Wait, wasn't I just here? Oh no, I'm going in circles. Maybe this wasn't the best idea.
Neil?
Oh!
Hmm.
Sorry, I didn't mean to sneak up on you. Hmm. Of course, I'm actually really glad you're here.
Huh?
Since you're in the defense guild, is there any chance you could help me out? Well, it's almost the 10th anniversary of when Basalt joined the defense guild. I wanted to get her something nice as a gift. But I got lost. And, oh, I should have made somebody clip that. There's a lot of monsters here.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I could help take you back to Borrelia safely. No, don't wait.
Neil?
I still want to get something for Basalt. Just feel safer if I wasn't alone.
Oh.
Oh, sure. I'm on my way to Entowol to talk to my old elder. Maybe we can find a gift there? That sounds good to me. Awesome, let's go! Do you have a crush on Basalt, maybe? I don't know. Ever since the gay frog, I'm seeing gay frogs everywhere. They gave me pie and it was delicious. So many directions. Worm. Mudman has worm. We'll give worm. Yes, if worm is what you truly desire, Mudman will give it to you. We'll take worm worm? Yes. Yes. Have worm now. Take.
Worm.
Mudman? Yeah, it's pretty good. I have a giant frog who's asking for worms. How many worms do I have? 5. Okay. I have 5 worms. I know where to come back to if I need to get more. You're the best. What would I do without you, Beetle Buddy? this is. This is my shortcut. To where? I do not know. Shortcuts are nice, and I'm sure I will use them later in the game when I'm traveling around, but for now, I prefer to explore. I cannot recommend it enough, Nomi, and I know Chameleon has also already put it on his wish list. Don't know if it's currently on sale. During the Steam sale, but yeah, this I can't recommend it enough. I kickstarted this, as I think I mentioned, and all I had was like, there's a cute frog and he's gonna go on adventures, and I was like, done. Take my money. Because they showed the cute frog, and it's like, oh, I can't. I need this game.
Oh, hello there.
Hi! I see you still have your tail. How long have you had your legs?
Oh, a couple of days now.
I remember when my legs grew in. It's so exciting.
Is it?
The water's safe. Everything outside of the water is so big. Who knows what's out there? Oh, I guess when I was little, I was so excited I never thought about things like that. Well, I can tell you, after being on land for years, it's not that bad. What if I get attacked by monsters? Or get hungry? Sure, there's a lot that can go wrong, but there's a lot of amazing things you can't experience if you stay in the water. I guess you're right. Do you need help getting out?
No.
I'll get out when I'm ready. Okay, take your time. Everybody can move at their own pace. Hey, what's it like being in the defense guild?
Oh,
I don't think I'm actually a part of it yet. Oh, I see. Well, I'm sure you'll get there soon enough. I mean, it's taking some serious feels to not rush back to where the giant frog who wants the worms is, and feed him worms, but I know I'll go back there, and it's really silly to try and go all the way back now, and then go all the way back again. The Lost Walk Tavern. I'll travel to Thank you. Welcome to the Lost Moth Inn.
Pub. It's the Lost Moth Pub.
I thought it was Tavern. No, she's right. It's Tavern. Welcome to the Lost Moth Tavern. Have a seat. What you want to talk about? My name's Lena. I cook most of the food. It's nice to meet you. I'm Ash, bartender. Let me know if you need anything. Don't take it personally if she doesn't talk to you much. She's just quiet. She's also the smart one. There's no way we could run this place without her.
Thanks.
Oh, you noticed us slipping up with the name of this place. We're new to running it. Used to just work here washing dishes and cooking and stuff. So the owner of this place was this cranky old jerk, right? One day he just up and leaves to travel the world or something. Like, what gives? I haven't even been here a month. So we get stuck running this place. But we decided to make the most of it. We're gonna make the Lost Moth Tavern better than it ever was. The best tavern this side of Salia. Better food, better decor, better pay. Hey, have you heard about the sneak thing? Giant monster that's coming to kill us, apparently. Going to burn down this whole forest. It's 100 feet tall and has big horns and razor sharp teeth. Okay, how scared this Cyfrog looks. It's gonna come stomping through Salia, leaving a trail of destruction and flames in its wake. Lena, you're scaring Belle. Safe travels. Come again soon. And don't forget Beetle Bunny. I've unofficially dubbed him Hank. She's a bad person, but she is kind of rude to me sometimes. I just feel like I need to prove myself to her. Well, just give her some time. Ah, ew! There's an air of adventure about you. I'm guessing you are an explorer. I used to be an explorer myself, before I took an arrow to the knee. No, wrong game. A treasure hunter, to be exact. Ah, but those days are long behind me. My name's Melis, what's yours? Of course. Have you ever heard of Lilystone's course? Beautiful little gems crafted by the ancients of Salia. When I carry one with me, I feel more determined. I'm sure it's merely a placebo, but if nothing else, they're nice to look at. There's plenty of lily stones hiding around our land. In fact, I believe I know where some are right now. If you'd like, I could mark the locations on your map for you. A treasure hunter's instinct is never wrong. Would you like me to mark the locations of lily stones on your map? Yes. Allow me 1 second. And done! Your map should now display the locations of any lily stones you have yet to find. I know some people would say no to that, but I'm not those people. I'm in it for the story. Don't have to make it too difficult on me. Play more games if they were more accessible like this one was. I actually have no idea how many games this chapter even has, or chapters this game even has. did it. Behold the sun's power harness! The rain themselves, controlled by the hands of Frog. That's a jar of fireflies and a watering can. Well, these components merely assist me in tuning to these powers. Seems as though these simple magics are not impressing to one such as yourself. Perhaps you would be more interested in deeper, stranger powers. Oh yes, the music is very nice. Soft play. Can you do that? I'm still figuring it out. Long journey. I made this previously. Technically, not me as a character, or me as a player, me as a character. Oh. Thanks, Beat Buddy. I would have missed it. Blood Child Talisman. Excuse me? Chasing eternal life, an ancient sect of frogs committed acts of force and destruction, seeking to free the mythical Blood Child. Well, that's a thing that just happened. Okay, then. Come out of nowhere, but you know, I mean, we've already got a murderous emperor, I guess, like, a secret frog cult is not that far out of the question. All types of frogs in this world, man, apparently. Say it takes all types to make the world go round, but maybe we don't need secret cult frogs. pray to summon a blood child. I just like that our reactions were very simple. I was like, excuse me? And you're like, what?
Hmm.
Can we stop for a moment?
Huh?
Are you okay? Yeah, I'm just... all of this is very overwhelming. We're almost to Entowol. There shouldn't be many monsters from here on.
Neil?
No, not that. Every day, I try harder and harder. I feel like I'm going to explode.
Huh?
One day, everybody in Borrelia is gonna depend on me. I'm just so scared. And I really want to get this gift right from Assault. She's just really cool.
Yeah.
I want to get something that'll make her happy. I want to make her happy.
Aya.
I wish I could help you with the elder training, but I don't know anything about being an elder. But I could try to help you figure out what to get from Assault. What sort of things does she like? She likes refurbishing old blades. Her favorite color is red. Oh, she really likes painting too.
What?
Assault paints? What kind of things does she paint? Mostly snails. Sometimes plants or other little creatures. But mostly snails. It's really cute. Cool. I meant cool. There's someone at Entowol who does powdery. Maybe you could get Basalt something to paint. Ooh, maybe a little dish. She can mix her colors on it.
Yeah.
Oh, and we could even get it shaped like a snail shell.
Ooh.
That sounds cute. How do you feel? I'm okay. It's gonna be okay. Thank you, Chorus. Let's keep going. No, a big coin? Oh no! Oh, sad face. Thank you.
Hello.
Hello?
Ha-ha.
Ah! Hello there, oh blessed one. May I ask your name?
Mia.
Of course. You don't need to do the whole...
Essa.
Oh, blessed chorus. May the soul mother protect... Mm. Hey, you don't need to do that whole fancy greeting thing. But you are a holy frog, are you not? No, actually, I'm a warrior. Oh, I see. Well, of course, the warrior, are you aware of the ancient holy practice of dream reading? I am, actually. I read my book. I think my old elder mentioned it once. Didn't the ancients of Salia study dreams? I think I passed by a dream meeting temple on my way to Borrelia.
Oh.
Yes, it is a custom dating back hundreds of years. Most believe the technique to be forgotten. However, of course, the warrior, some still exist today who are trained in the art of dream reading. These individuals are a rare few, and one would find it quite challenging to locate such an individual.
Wow.
Hello today, Chorus the Warrior. You have found yourself in quite the lucky scenario. You're a dream reader. Hmm. My friend, I am a dream reader. Yeah.
Why?
I am a servant of fate itself, hearing its voice through my holy hat. As a matter of fact, Chorus the Warrior, if you describe to me what you dreamt of last night, I shall translate what fate has in store for you. For a reasonable fee, of course. A dream reading will cost you 100. Fine, why not? Let's do it. Excellent, now we shall begin. Now please describe last night's dream to me. It started with beautiful music, and then I realized I had something important to do. Then there was a large fight, then finally my old elder showed up, and then I woke up. Ah, yes, I see.
Wah-hoo.
Chorus the Warrior, I can hear fate speaking as you describe this dream to me. This is what fate has to say to you. You are capable of great things. That's it. All sales are final. Thank you for your patronage. Yep, that was a waste of 100. But, oh well. I'll get it back. And I'm just gonna... There's any guides out for this because it's brand new. We just launched like this month or last month, I can't remember. Nope. Nothing on. Thank you. Reina, this is Aria. She's the one who does the pottery. Hello. I was wondering if you were able to make a dish for me? Sure, what kind? While you get this figured out, I'll go on ahead and find Elder Akros and talk with him. Right. Thanks, Chorus. Hello, Chorus. I've been practicing my singing. Care to listen? Sure. It was beautiful. Absolutely amazing. My old house. I should probably clear out the rest of this junk sometime. It's Muffy! I can't believe I forgot her here. I used to not be able to sleep without this thing. I guess I better take her home so I don't forget again. Activity around that giant ancient structure. The one with the strange, twisty tower. It was struck by lightning earlier this morning. An ominous omen, I would say. The structure is in close proximity to the great city of Tara, though it is great in name only. A wretched place it is. Something odious is brewing from the depths of depravity in that old structure, methinks. Okay. Best to stay away from those bullfrog folks, I'd say. Okay. Words of the wise, my little beerescent friend. You must use more words when you speak, or else no one will know how smart you are. Okay. Living things have a soul. The souls come from this weird ball of sword goop that Inara takes care of. She sings a special song to take some of the goop and put it in a body when a creature is born. Then when you die, your soul gets recycled back into the goop ball. I think there was a proper name for the goop ball, but I can't remember it. This here is Om, the Worm Father. He and Inara are kind of responsible for making every living creature together. Apparently, he makes bodies for a living creature out of dirt or something for Inara to put souls into. Then when you die and the worms eat you, you turn back into dirt again. Dirt and goop, that's what we're all made of. That's the blood child. Nobody really talks about it. I'm trying to remember the story behind this one. I think the blood child was the first child of Inara, and it started killing everything around it. Then Inara turned it into a monster as punishment? Actually, maybe it turned into a monster first and then started killing stuff? It got banished or locked up or something too, I think? I don't really remember. A lot of the old stories have weird, dark, meaningless stuff nobody likes talking about. Everyone likes talking about the poetic, happy stuff. Like the fact that we're all gonna turn into dirt and goop. So soon? I take it you did not last long in the Defense Guild. Shame, but fate has a place for all of us, I suppose. Good afternoon, Elder Akris of Tensol. I am here to deliver a message on behalf of the Defense Guild of Borrelia. Is that so? Lord Lithos, ruler of the Tarl Empire, has been traveling to different villages, attempting to convince them to join his empire. He has also been spreading rumors of a monster known as the Snaked. We believe the purpose of these rumors is to spread fear, making the elders of the villages easier to convince. Of course, there's no need to act so formal with me. I am your elder, remember? I have known you since you are a tadpole. Come now, don't be a stranger. Tell me more about this beast. Rumors say it's a giant monster capable of terrible destruction. Well, but that's not the point. You always were a fan of monster stories. You do not need the Tauril Empire to protect us. This creature sounds like a hoax. That's what I'm trying to tell you. The name, the Schnicked, does not ring a bell. But even if we assumed it was real, we would simply need to send a warrior with the Sunblade to face it. One jab from the Sunblade and it would surely perish.
Huh?
Wait, the Sunblade is real? I thought it was just a story.
Huh.
Of course it's real. How else do you think Anora would have been able to rid the world of all magical beasts? Of course, do not let these monster stories get to you. The life of a Defense Guild member promises much excitement, but it is a dangerous path. It's no place for a frog like you. I know you are smarter than this.
Oh.
I don't know what else I expected from this. Look, just watch out for Lissless's Empire, okay? That's all I came here to say. When you're a Dunblane soldier, you're always welcome to come back home.
Huh.
This is not my home, and you are not my elder. Excuse me? I left this place because people like you refuse to accept me. Nobody in this village wants to see the real me. I haven't been welcome here for a long time.
Huh.
You are being ridiculous. All I have ever done for you is nurture you and help you grow. I want what is best for you. No, you don't. You just want what makes you comfortable. I've already done what I came here for. I'm going home to Aurelia. Goodbye, Akris. The book is open to a passage, read it? Yes. And the Greaseler coiled about, splattering the grass with athletic froth. The Greaseler let out a horrendous shriek and lunged at Dash. At last Dask spoke, I shall deliver thee to thy worm father. Dask drew his blade and swung. All was quiet in the forest for a moment. The wretched beast would prey upon villages no longer. Dask's work was done. Next page has an illustration of a frog with a blindfold on, hiding from a monster that looks like a cross between a rat and a snake with way too many legs. Stay away from my bacon, huh? Actually, I'm here on Defense Guild business. But maybe some frog butts wouldn't be bad. Ha, of course they wouldn't. Remember that one Mud Moon feast, a few years ago when I made the biggest batch of frog buns ever? And then you ate so many you were sore for a week? I was only sore for a day. They're good, okay? Frog buns heal 2 lilies each. You can buy a bag of 4 frog buns for 80. Buy some frog buns? Nah, that's okay. I'm sure you'll be back soon. Welcome back, Chorus. Chorus, right. Sorry, I'm still getting used to your new name. It's okay, I get it. It's going to take some time. No, really, I'm sorry. I keep forgetting. It's fine, really. I should know better. I'm sorry. It's okay. Speak up a bit, my eyes and ears aren't what they once were. Hello, Grand Cadence. It's Chorus. Ah, Chorus. You were always my favorite pupil. I was? I was always distracted. I was always doodling in my notes. Ah, but your doodles were always so cute. And look at you now, you've gone off to join the Defense Guild like you've always dreamed. Everyone else here thinks that's weird. Have I ever told told you about why our village was named Entowol? No, I don't think so. Or maybe you did and I forgot. The old stories say that long ago there used to be two moons. The Eastern Moon and the Western Moon. The Eastern Moon was raised by a child of Enora named Palin. The Western Moon was raised by a child of Enora named Ten. One day, Ten grew tired of controlling her moon. She came down to our world. She saw Mika's beautiful plants and decided she wanted to make some herself. Instead of the green plants Miku made, Ten made plants of all sorts of colors. Yeah. She created flowers. Huh. Where does the fall part in Ten's fall come from then? Well, Enora didn't like that Ten did, so... did that, so she killed her. Oh. My point is that if Ten did not stray from the path, we would not have flowers. And we certainly do not miss the other moon. Our village has plenty of people to raise the moon. You, Chorus, you are creating flowers. I love Cadence. Grand Cadence is my new favorite person. Actually take him up on the ride because I want to go feed worms to people. Borrelia. Oh, look at the cute animation! Oh my gosh! Stay safe out there. Thank you, Chorus. Really, it means a lot that you helped me out. Oh, it was no problem, really. I'm just glad I could help someone. That's the whole reason I'm here. But... sorry, I should go report back to Elder Bufo. See you around, Chorus. Uh-oh. She's stuck following me. Nope, I gotta go find the worms first. Worm dude first. I gotta see if I bought enough worms, or got enough worms. Okay, there he is. I am here, and he is up here.
Oh.
They brought me worms. I do have some worms on me. Would little fella give me worms? Yes. We'll eat worm now. Little snack. Little fella is now welcome and home. Little snack. Maybe little fella will bring more worms? Another worm.
Mm-hmm.
think that's it. I have no idea if that does anything ever. But I have done it now. I will have to get some more worms. Well, 5 was a pretty good number, but it says I'm welcome at home, but that didn't really change anything. So unless I have to wait till tomorrow for it to change something. Say I'm probably gonna get off stream after this chapter ends when I have the opportunity to save and quit, because I had a long day and I've been streaming almost 3 hours and I have some other stuff I want to get done tonight before I go to bed. So thank you to everybody that has hung out with me. I don't know when the chapter is going to end, but I suspect it will be soon.
Hiya.
How did it go? I think it went okay. I mean, I think Tensfall is going to be fine. Well, that's as good. The other warriors have told me they were successful in Redwood and Clear Bay as well. But Salt is likely still on her way back. Mossfin is a bit of a trek, especially in this weather. She will likely be back tomorrow morning. Yeah, I had, something I wanted to ask Elder Bufo. Oh? Why do you believe in me? I mean, don't get me wrong, I appreciate it, but nobody else does. Technically, Grand Cadence does, so not entirely correct on that, but small. I'm not as strong or as skilled as Basalt or anyone else, really. Are you just being nice? Oh, of course. Has anyone told you about what happened to my leg? No. If you asked anyone why I was missing, they would surely tell you that I lost it in the war. That is what I have told everyone for years. But that is not true.
Real.
I was born without it. I joined the Defense Guild as a young frog, just as the war was emerging. I wanted to protect the people of Salia so badly. I was certain they would turn me away because of my leg, but I was allowed to join. Not all frogs are built the same, but everyone deserves a chance at their dreams. When I came home from the war, I wanted to seem strong. I told everyone that I lost my leg in a brutal fight. Truth be told, I was rarely involved in combat. The only lie I have ever told the villagers, but I have kept it up for so long. I feared that if they found out I've been lying all this time, they would never trust me again. But I must admit, seeing how you've never let your size stop you, it's made me rethink some things. Perhaps I will tell the others. Oh, I really think you should. The people here already care about you. They're not going to stop if you tell them the truth. Well, I suppose you are right. Thank you, Chorus. I am feeling quite tired now. We have done the best we can about this Lithos situation. For now, we must wait and hope for the best. I think it is time for this old frog to get some rest. I will speak with you tomorrow, Chorus. Yeah, as I suspected, that's the end of chapter. Unless I felt like running all the way over to Worm Dude and getting some more worms and then bringing them back, but I'm not really sure I feel like that right this second. I do feel like putting Moffy out, though. Did I get anything else new? I got a little stone thingy. All right. I think it's time to rest. Chapter 4, The Storm. All right, everyone.
Thank you so much for coming.
I see some of you have been lurking, and that's cool. I'm glad you lurked. I hope you enjoyed the silly, cute, adorable frogs as much as I did. And I will be back with Chapter 4 next Tuesday. If I stream, I've decided that my main game is going to be only on Tuesdays, so like, that way people can plan for it if they don't want to miss the next part of the story and that sort of thing. But after, if I stream again this weekend, it'll be something different. I've got a couple other games on, like West of Loathing came out with an expansion, so I've technically got a West of Loathing game I can play on stream, and a couple other things that I could mess around with, some small games, that sort of thing. So I will see you next time. If not sometime this weekend, then I will see you Tuesday. Love you. Thanks for coming. Have a wonderful night, day, evening, morning, whatever. Whatever is going on with you. And mwah! Bye-bye!